Before starting the video, do not forget to subscribe the channel. And after subscribing the channel, do not forget to hit the bell icon so that you never miss an update of my videos. So let's start the video.
Hello guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel SK Crazy Vlogs. So you all must be aware that from 25th of May we are starting with our domestic flights. But all the airline operators and passengers have to follow certain guidelines to prevent spreading of coronavirus. So in this video I'm going to tell you the guidelines which all the passengers have to follow if they wish to travel in any of the airlines. So I request you all to please watch this video from starting to end without skipping. So let's start the video. Firstly, all the passengers have to follow the norms of social distancing and maintain minimum touching. Secondly, passengers have to show their health status on Arogya Setu app, else they have to fill a self-declaration form. Payments will be accepted digitally via debit or credit cards, and passengers are supposed to use only authorized cabs. As of now, only one check-in bag and one carry bag will be allowed. Vulnerable people such as elderly, pregnant ladies, passengers with ailments means other diseases are advised to avoid air travel. Passengers have to do a web check-in for themselves before reaching the airport, and at the airport they can request for a boarding pass. Passengers have to download the baggage tag, print it and affix it on their bags at a prominent place. However, in any case, if the passenger is not able to print the baggage tag, then he or she should mention their PNR number, his or her name on a thick piece of paper and affix it with a strong string. Before entering the terminal, passengers have to ensure that he or she is wearing a mask. As per revised timings, now passengers have to report at the airport at least 2 hours prior to the departure of their flight. Passengers have to travel only in authorized taxis or their personal vehicles. And while the passenger is on the way to the airport, he has to take all the precautions to prevent infection. After reaching the airport, passenger has to certify the status of his or her health through Arogya Setu app or by filling a self-declaration form. Passengers have to reach the airport on time. If a passenger is staying in a containment zone, then he or she is not supposed to travel. And lastly, if a passenger is being tested positive for COVID-19, he or she is not supposed to travel. If a passenger who is not permitted to fly undertakes any air journey, he or she will be liable for penal action. All passengers have to give a self-declaration, and points are mentioned on your screen, you can read. Airlines have to ensure that the boarding pass is issued only after the passenger confirms the above declaration. And lastly, if in case a PNR is having more than one passenger, then the declaration would be deemed to be covering all the passengers mentioned in the PNR. Passengers have to wear the mask throughout the journey. At the airport, passengers have to get down from their vehicle with their face mask on and with the required documents. Then the passenger have to arrive at the thermal screening facility near the entry gate, where the passenger have to get himself checked for temperature and has to display the Arogya Setu app status to the staff at the entry gate. In case of non-availability of Arogya Setu app in the passenger's cell phone, passengers should be facilitated to go to a counter provided by the airport where Arogya Setu app can be downloaded. Then passenger has to show his or her identity card and the e-boarding pass to the CISF staff at the entry gate. After entering the terminal, passenger has to proceed to the baggage drop counter, show his or her PNR to the staff, and passengers should avoid using baggage trolleys as far as possible. An electronic receipt for the baggage will be sent to the passenger via SMS. Passengers to adhere to the social distancing, which would be specified at the airport through markings like circles, squares or tension barriers. Passengers have to complete the check-in procedure and baggage drop at least 60 minutes prior to the departure. Arrangements have been made at the airports to guide the passengers to walk through the pre-embarkation security screening. Passengers have to follow the directions as announced by the authorities and remove all the metal items from their body to facilitate the security screening. Passengers can carry only one hand luggage as per the specified size allowed by the particular airlines in which they are traveling. And all the passengers have to cooperate with the security staff by following the instructions for his or her own safety and security. After the screening is done, passenger has to proceed to the security hold area. While waiting for boarding at the security hold area, passenger have to maintain social distancing and sanitization protocols. Chairs which are marked not for use should not be occupied at any cost. While going around for food and beverages or retail outlets, passengers should be aware of the social distancing and maintain hygiene as well. Passengers should also be aware of the locations where sanitizers would be made available at the airport. And lastly, passengers to dispose all the biohazardous materials like masks, gloves, tissues, etc. in the yellow colored disposable bins or bags placed at strategic locations at the airport. While boarding, passengers have to be attentive towards the various communication material displayed at the airport about various health advisories relating to pre-boarding and during the flight precautions. Passengers have to collect the safe ticket, that is their three-layered surgical mask and sanitizer, from the airline staff near the boarding gate. Passengers have to wear a mask and sanitize their hands before proceeding to the boarding gate for scanning the boarding pass. Passengers need to be attentive towards the boarding announcements and read the boarding queue by following the social distancing. Displaying of identity cards by passengers is a must, and check-in of the boarding pass would be done by the passenger by self-scanning of e-boarding pass. During the flight, passengers to strictly follow hygiene and sanitization, and face-to-face interaction should be minimized. Passengers should minimize the use of toilets and avoid any non-essential movements in the aisle. No queuing will be allowed at the toilets, and only one companion for children and the elderly would be allowed. No meal service will be allowed in the aircraft. Water bottles will be available in the galley area or on the seats. Eatables not to be consumed during the flight. No newspaper or magazine will be available, and no onboard sale of any item. During the flight, if any passenger feels uncomfortable, fatigued, or has respiratory distress, it should be brought to the immediate notice of the cabin crew. After reaching the destination, the disembarkation process from the airlines would be sequential. To disembark, passengers have to strictly follow the instructions of the cabin crew. Social distancing and sanitization should be maintained at the arrival gate, aerobridges, coaches, jet ladders, ramps, etc. And lastly, trolleys in the arrival area should be used cautiously or should be avoided. Passengers have to wait at the baggage hold area till their baggage arrives in batches, and transit passengers will not be allowed to come out of the transit area. After exiting the airport, passengers can only hire authorized taxis to commute back to home. Passengers have to follow social distancing and hygiene while traveling in any mode of transportation. And on arrival at the destination, passengers to adhere to health protocols as prescribed by the destination state or union territory. Well, I've tried to cover most of the points which will be required by any traveler who wishes to travel in any of the airlines. But still, if you have any queries, you can refer to the websites visible on the screen, that is www.civilaviation.gov.in, mohfw.gov.in, or corona.mygov.in. You can also call on 1075 helpline number, which is a toll-free number. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. I hope you found this video really informative. And if you really liked the video, please hit the like button as well. Do not forget to share this video with your friends and family members so that they can also be aware of the new guidelines for domestic flights. You can also follow me on Instagram, and you can see my Instagram handle flashing on the screen right now. And if you're visiting my channel for the first time, don't forget to subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon as well so that you never miss an update of my videos. So it's time to end the video, guys. I'll see you again in my next video soon. Till then, take care of your health. Bye bye.